ओके ठीक है. टुडे वी डिस्कस मेडिको लीगल इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ डेथ. चैप्टर ऑफ थैनेटोलॉजी दिस कवर्स ऑल द लीगल मेडिकल एंड मेडिको लीगल एस्पेक्ट्स. The medico-legal aspects of death is the declaration of death, certification of death, notification of death, registration of death, disposal of dead body, organ transplantation, and presumption of death. Declaration of death is the most important duty of registered medical practitioner. How we determine death is matter of his choice, whether apply local, national or international methods. Some usually inspect, some palpate the peripheral pulses or carotid pulse, some auscultate or others require a flat ECG, electrocardiogram. Certification of death, recognition of the phenomena and cause of death is called certification. If a doctor knows the cause of death and the cause of death is natural, he may issue death certificate. In some countries, doctor must have seen and treated the patient before death, whereas in other countries, any doctor who has seen, examined the body of after death may issue death certificate. Declaration of death and certification of death is a prime responsibility of registered medical practitioner. Notification of death is information about the incidence of death. Registration, it is a recording of death in the death register to be maintained by the corporation after receiving information about death. Notification and registration of death is the prime responsibility of the head of family and district boards, municipalities, metropolitan corporation, town committees. The notification and registration of death, the prime responsibility lies on the head of family. Declaration and certification of death as a medical aspect, notification and registration is a legal aspect. Disposal of dead body, both medical and legal aspects. No disposal order of dead body issued unless cause of death is not established. Disposal of dead bodies done according to custom, culture, rituals, and religious beliefs. There are four modes of disposal of dead body. The most important is burial. Is most of the Muslim, all Muslims, Jews dispose their dead body by means of burial. Cremation most of the non-Muslims dispose dead body by means of cremation and incineration. In cremation, all medico-legal evidence would be lost. The only post-cremation evidence that has ever been obtained concerns thallium poisoning. This may be BCQ. The all toxicological evidence lost in cremation except thallium poisoning. It can be isolated from the ashes of the burnt body. Silent Tower, a Parsi sect, disposed their dead body. By means of silent tower, a religious building, put the body over the top of that building where vultures came and tear the body. And some dispose their bodies, dead bodies, in water. These are the four methods of disposal of dead body. Organ transplantation. Both has medical, legal, and medico-legal aspects. It's a separate topic. One should go through ethical consideration, social, legal, religious, and medico-legal aspects. Recently, Sindh Assembly passed a bill of Adib Rizvi in which he demanded of cadaver organ transplantation. It will reduce the kidney theft and other issues most common in our society. Presumption of death. The Evidence Act lay down that if a person is proved to have been alive within 30 years, the legal presumption is that he is still alive. Unless it is proved that he has not been heard of for 7 years by those who could normally have heard of him. In case of inheritance cases, divorce, remarriage, it is necessary to declare person or presume person as dead. This is known as presumption of death. This is totally a legal aspect of death. Presumption of survivorship. Another purely legal matter. Suppose in a recently there is a air crash couple of days ago at Karachi, and almost all passengers were died. To resolve the business matter, inheritance claims, what law presume that healthy survive of diseased, man survive of woman, adult survive of children? What law presume? Although they may simultaneously may die, but what law presume that adult survive of children, man survive of women, healthy survive of disease? Cause, mechanism, mode, manner of death. This is a commonly asked question as a short question in theory. Define cause, mechanism, mode, and manner of death. Cause of death has medical component, circumstantial evidence, that there may be immediate cause of death, proximate cause of death with certainty, probability, conjectural, and undetermined. A medical component, evidence of injury, intoxication, or disease, and the results of ancillary services. Ancillary services means toxicology, biochemistry, virology, radiology, histopathology, all these included in ancillary services with the help of sending visras to detect the cause of death. Another, the circumstantial evidence. In our country, this is furnished by police. Doctor never visit the scene of crime. It includes anamnestic data collected from the victim and other person attending the victim during terminal illness. It includes statement of witnesses about the circumstances and behavior of the victim at the terminal stage of along with any medical background information of the deceased from family, friend, doctor, or from medical institute. The cause of death may be immediate, that a injury, intoxication, disease may directly lead to the death of deceased. Our cause of death may be proximate, when natural disease process or injury or event that led to a uninterrupted train of events, weeks, months, even years, that eventually led to the individual's death. What is the difference between the immediate cause of death and proximate? Immediate cause of death, the injury is sufficient to cause death in ordinary course of nature. A fracture of a skull with massive bleeding, firearm injury. In proximate cause of death, injury is not sufficient to cause death in ordinary course of nature, but due to consequences and complications of the injury, which has train of events led to the death of disease. Certainty regarding cause of death depends on many variables. First is the post-mortem examination. Second, reports from ancillary services, which reveals cause of death without doubt. Probability is the cause of death is interpreted from anamnestic facts. Anamnestic facts, as mentioned earlier, is a circumstantial evidence, the information about the deceased from record, hospitalization, other things. Because the post-mortem findings being non-specific. For example, in epilepsy, electrocution. There are many causes of negative autopsy. So a forensic expert can infer the cause of death from the facts provided to him or the facts observed by him. Conjectural, where neither anamnestic data nor the postmortem findings and lab studies reveals the cause of death. For example, most of the anesthetic deaths fall in this category. Undetermined, in highly decomposed bodies, in skeletonized bodies, postmortem examination as well as lab investigation fails to reveal the cause of death. Undetermined also has some value. A negative finding carries significance in dispelling allegation of injuries, poisoning, which might have alleged to have caused some role towards death. Mechanism. A trend of events in the body physiology or biochemistry, which is incompatible with life. For example, asystole, ventricular fibrillation, acidosis, alkalosis, hemorrhagic shock, toxemia, paralysis. All these are the mechanism of death. Mode of death. In my first lecture, I told you the Bichet's triad, the tripod of life: innervation, circulation, and respiration. So the mode depend on these three tripods of life. Coma is a failure of the function of the brain, or failure of innervation. Syncope, failure of the function of the heart, a failure of circulation. Asphyxia, failure of the function of respiration. This classification refers to mode of dying. Is useful to the lawyers and laymen for interpretation of medical evidence as cause of death. Coma may result from traumatic injury, that is traumatic head injury, toxic, opium, barbiturate, alcohol, chloroform, inert gases, carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, hydrogen sulfide, metabolic, diabetes mellitus, uremia, infective, meningitis, abscesses, miscellaneous, there may be epilepsy, heat stroke. Syncope, traumatic, there is injury to the heart, a stab injury, stab wound in the heart causes cardiac tamponade. Toxic, the cardiac poisons, digitalis, digoxin, aconite. Pathological, there is pathology of myocardium, endocardium, pericardium, heart valves, conducting system, anemia, high output failure, miscellaneous, overexercise, exhaustion. Asphyxia is traumatic. There may be injury to the lungs. Toxic, opium, barbiturate, carbon dioxide, hydrogen sulfide, chloroform, phocine, cyanides. Pathological, that means pathology of the lungs, paralysis of the muscles. A toxic may also include cobra venom, curare, muscle relaxants, the most important is mechanical. Mechanical causes compression of neck, occlusion of external passages by smothering, the occlusion of internal passages by choking, gagging, traumatic asphyxia, hanging, strangulation. Another classification of mode is given by Gordon's classification. This classification refers to pathogenesis of death. Gordon postulated that in all forms of death, the fundamental pathology changes are uniform in nature, depends upon availability and utilization of oxygen by the body tissues, in whichever way it occurs. Gordon described classified mode under four headings: anoxic anoxia, stagnant anoxia, anemic anoxia, histotoxic anoxia. Anoxic anoxia: no oxygen at all, obstruction in the external air passages, suffocation, smothering, obstruction in the internal air passages due to foreign body, choking, drowning, throttling, hanging, strangulation, by external pressure on chest wall. This is the one way to catch up the criminals. As you witness recently in America, a black person died due to police. This way of police to give pressure over the chest and arm in the neck. This is a neck sleeper, neck hold. The failure of respiratory center, opium, barbiturate, alcohol. Breathing in atmosphere containing inert gases, hydrogen sulfide, carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide. All the causes anoxic anoxia. Stagnant anoxia is lack of oxygen due to inefficient circulation of blood in tissues. Heat stroke, shock, congestive cardiac failure. Anemic anoxia, a lack of oxygen due to reduction of oxygen carrying capacity of hemoglobin. Anemia, hemorrhage, carbon monoxide. The carbon monoxide have 250 times more affinity to bind with hemoglobin as compared to the oxygen. Histotoxic anoxia, lack of tissue oxygenation or inability of tissues to utilize oxygen. This may be extracellular, caused by the poisons chloroform or ether. Chloroform is a sedative hypnotic, ether is a gas, anesthetic gas. Intracellular, hydrogen sulfide. At the cellular level, cyanide, barbiturate. The metabolic, uremia. All they interfere with the utilization of oxygen by the tissues. Next come the manner. Manner of death may be natural or unnatural or violent. Unnatural, violent is accidental, suicidal or homicidal, or undetermined, when all the investigation postmortem fails to reveal the manner of death. Natural due to disease process, unnatural there may be accidental, suicidal, self-harming, homicidal by others. Thank you very much. You may ask question. Hello, can you hear me? Hello?
हेलो सर
जी
सर आपने एक स्लाइड शो की थी जिसमें आपने जो है वो बताया था कि बॉडी को तब तक डिस्पोज नहीं करेंगे अंचल हमें उस डेथ का कॉज नहीं पता हो सर. तो यूजुअली जो कल्चर्स होते हैं या फिर सर नेचुरल डेथ हो रही है तो सर उसमें कॉज की तरफ तो कोई जाता ही नहीं. लाइक मतलब दे आर जस्ट ईगर टू बरी दैट बॉडी और जस्ट डिस्पोज दैट बॉडी. तो ये कहाँ पे अप्लाई होगा?
कोमल कोमल पूछ रहे हो? कौन पूछ रहा है?
यस सर.
हाँ, क्या है
कोमल कोमल
एक्चुअली रजिस्ट्रेशन नोटिफिकेशन सर्टिफिकेशन एंड डिक्लेरेशन ऑल्दो द लॉ इज देयर बट नॉट प्रैक्टिस्ड इन आवर कंट्री ओनली व्हेन द डेथ अकर्स इन हॉस्टल प्रिजन आर इन एनी इंस्टीट्यूट देन देयर इज अ डेथ सर्टिफिकेशन इज अप्लाइड अदरवाइज we take death certificate or death registration whenever we have some legal formalities to be fulfilled for a scholarship for immigration like that. So unfortunately this is not practiced in well established society. If cause of death is not established, there will be no disposal order from the registrar of the municipal committee, town committee, union council to bury that person. If the person died of criminal activity, he is criminal, even no orders sanction to bury him into a graveyard. This is the highest punishment. Any other question?
Yes sir. Sir, please explain survivorship.
Survivor, this is a legal ke, suppose all passengers died in a single crash and all family members are there, they have they run the business. So who's the next successor? Although they die simultaneously, but what law presume that the healthy survive of disease, male survive of female, and adult survive of children. This is what law presumes.